and we will cut open the kidney. And you'll see many interesting things here. Wait, slowly, Joe. Yes. Go.
Can you
okay, the purple gloves, nitrile gloves add color to the dissection, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, otherwise it's all white and brown.
Yeah.
It is kind of
okay.
I know. Now give me that knife please for me. What we do is after we have made the initial incision, we have cut through the cortex, we just separate it out like that. And now put your finger. Do it.
Wow.
Yes. Wonderful. Good job.
Very good job.
Okay.
Oh my goodness.
Who is going to describe the parts for me? So my assistants have cut open the left kidney along its longitudinal axis, and we have opened it up like a book, and we are seeing the interior of the left kidney. So straight away we can see three parts of the kidney. First of all, we can see the outermost portion right under the capsule of the kidney. That is the cortex, and it is lighter in color, and we can see the cortex on this side also. Then we can see the slightly more pigmented inner portion. That is called the medulla. And further we see the pelvic calcium system in the center. The cortex is the place where the blood vessels ramify. Let's come to the pigmented portion, the medulla. The most prominent thing which comes strikes our eye is this pyramidal shaped structure here with its striated appearance. This is referred to as the medullary pyramids, also called the medullary rays because they contain the collecting ducts of Bellini which meet at the apex, and the apex is called the renal papilla. In between the pyramids we have these lightly pigmented areas, and that is referred to as the renal columns of Bertini, which allow passage to the blood vessels. Coming back to the apex, the papilla, they communicate with the concavity of the minor calyx, and that is where urine is ultrafiltered into the minor calyx, and that's how the urine is produced. One renal pyramid plus part of the renal column on one side and the part of the renal column on the other side. This whole thing is referred to as one renal lobe. That is what we see here. And finally, this is the region of the pelvic calcium system, but that it contains not only the renal pelvis and the calyces, but we also see the blood vessels. We can see branches of the renal veins and the renal arteries as they enter through the hilum and then they ramify here. The cortex contains the glomerulus, the Bowman's capsule, the proximal convoluted tubules, distal convoluted tubules, and part of the loop of Henle. The renal medulla contains the collecting ducts and also contain the axial loops of Henle, the major part of it. So these are what is seen in the cut section of the kidney. In case of hydronephrosis, this whole thing gets filled with urine and the medulla and the cortex gets atrophied, and that condition is referred to as hydronephrosis. And if it's filled with pus, it is referred to as pyonephrosis. We can have a calculus inside this pelvic calcium system, and that is called a Staghorn calculus, which usually occurs from infection, especially by Proteus mirabilis. Since we are already on the left side, I would draw your attention to an abnormality that we noticed in this kidney. We can see the soft area here. This is a renal cyst that we can see here. And I'm going to puncture the renal cyst to show you the content inside. And we have punctured it, and we can see that watery fluid and these things are draining out. So this is a renal cyst, a solitary renal cyst. Three renal cyst on the posterior aspect of the left kidney, and my assistant is very assiduously cutting the margins of the cyst. And I'm holding it up for him and he is cutting. Well, so far he has cut it professionally. Let's see how he does the rest of the job. So we are de-roofing the margin of the cyst. Now you reverse your scissor. Don't go into the normal tissue, please. Yes. Leave that for somebody else. Okay. So we have de-roofed the cyst. And this is the interior of the cyst. This gelatinous material was inside the cyst. It's anchovy sauce. Here. Snip this off, please, for me, Baba Tunde. Good. So this is the interior of the cyst. There is another cyst on the left side, and that is the location here. This is a small renal cyst that you can see here. Snip this off also. It's already out. Okay. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please put them in the comment section below. Dr. Sanjoy Sanyal signing out. Have a nice day.